Vlad or Nicola, and he gets in all sorts of troubles and situations. And it's for those of you who were in the classes where we were before, this Colas is a song that is usually danced by couples. It's not around, I'm gonna dance it on my own, what I gonna do. But usually in the Fandango, which is the traditional celebration of Son Jarocho, Colas is a couples dance.
Thank you. Or to your women.
And they sing this song called Balafu, and it's about the illusions that people who spend too long at sea start seeing when they don't see anyone else or nothing else. And a lot of the times, many of the times, the illusions are about love. And this is what this song is about.
Thank you.
Juana, pues lo que ocurre es que el cantador le dice a los bailadores qué tienen que hacer con qué parte del cuerpo, porque los bailadores son como iguanas que tienen que moverse conforme les diga el cantador. Normalmente en el fandango, en la iguana, el bailador hombre se luce como iguana y quiere ser la mejor iguana del fandango. This next song is called Iguana. And the iguana, the singer tells the dancers what they have to move, what part of the body, because the dancers have to be kind of like iguanas. And in the fandango, the traditional celebration of São Caruto, men usually who dance the iguana want to be the best iguana of the fandango. So we're gonna see if there are any iguanas among us.
Thank you.
We are going to play this next song called La Morena. And so in the San Jarocho tradition, there are three main groups. The Spanish, the Mexican indigenous, and also the Afro-Mexican. People from Western Africa were brought to Mexico as slaves during the colonial period. And many people know this, but what many people don't know is that those slaves were many more than people initially believed, and that they created communities of their own when some of them were runaways, some of them when they were free. They created their own communities in parts of Mexico, and their contributions to Mexican culture are huge. And we call them the third root of Mexican culture, the third root of San Jarocho. Afro-Mexicans are definitely a big, important part of Mexican culture in general. So Morena celebrates that contribution and the legacy of Afro-Mexicans in Veracruz.
Thank you.
Does anyone want to ask something about this music? Say something?
Can you tell us about the instruments?
Of course. So we have, to my right, the Juan Carlos is playing a requinto, requinto jarocho, or guitarra de son. It's a four-string instrument. It beats the melody of the music. And it's played with the pick that's made usually out of a bull's horn. This one is not, it's made out of a cone, but there's another one there. Yeah, that's that actual made of bull horn. Then this one right here is a jarana, and this is the sort of the rhythm guitar, and it's strung usually. And there are many different sizes. There's a big family of jaranas. This is a jarana tercera, and which is a low pitch sound. Then it comes the segunda, then the primera, first, second, and third, and then a small, tiny little jarana called mosquito, and even a tinier one that's like this big called chaquito. And those are like very high pitch sound. Then we have the leona, or the bass family, and you might see it and find a resemblance with the guitarrón that mariachis play. It's a little different, but it's basically the bass of the music. It's four strings and also played with the bull's horn, that pick. And then the marimbol is also a bass instrument, but it's also, it kind of works like a bass, it almost has a percussive sound to it, I think. And the marimbol is a more recent addition to son jarocho. All of these instruments are from the sort of the original, the colonial period, I would say, except for the marimbol, which was brought into this tradition, I don't know, like maybe half of the 20th century or so. What else? We have another jarana, and obviously we have the upright bass, and that's our own addition. I mean, other son jarocho groups play with upright bass as well, but we added to our music. And then the tarima, which is the foot stomping, that's what they call, and some of you may have heard me say at the class, like the heart of the music, because it leads, it kind of has a heartbeat. And it's the heart of the fandango as well, this community celebration, because there's usually a big tarima where people dance and everybody else gathers around the tarima and plays and sings. And then the poetry, a lot of the times it's improvised, not this time. This time we have the verses that we usually sing. But poetry is a huge important part of the son jarocho tradition, and many people improvise. It's a very improvised type of music in the poetry sense.
Yeah, I
mean,
you hear a lot of South American
actual sort of the musical structure of it, and maybe they can say a few words. I would say that with Latin American music and the relationship with Spanish music is sort of twofold. It's really of communication, as opposed to Spain brought its music into the Americas and then we kind of like stay there and we just adapt it. And I think Latin American music traveled to Spain quite a bit as well. Like you have in flamenco, for example, in the dance you have guajiras, or you have colombianas, which you know are basically la petenera. La petenera is originally a traditional song from Mexico, but now in flamenco they dance by peteneras. That's what they say. And so I think that there was definitely an influence, Spanish influence, excuse me, but also Latin American music influenced Spain as well. So now we're not exactly sure what's the exact origin of a lot of these music, but I don't know if you want to say something about the Coroco and the Venezuelan and Colombian.
Can everyone hear me? Just very briefly to that, there are some theories that, so you find similar instrumentation both in Veracruz, Paraguay, Venezuela, and Colombia. you know, this modern day nation states, basically, they didn't exist back then. But the, one of the theories of travels is by the Jesuit orders, traveling to these places and setting up. And then now we have, you know, what we're hearing correctly. I mean, I'm calling it the first experience I had in San Francisco was like, oh, it sounds like music from Venezuela, Colombia. So there are these linkages from the past that we shouldn't be rash to write that about, but you know, you can definitely see a pan Latin American sort of circuit there.
Thank you so much. We're gonna start saying farewell with this last song that you will know, and you might not know that it's a traditional song from Veracruz, Mexico, and it's very old. If Bueno, soy Sandra Mozart, de, like I was saying, the community celebration. So there's a Jarocho community here in New York that participates in these fandangos. Everybody's welcome. So please, you know, just join us one time, one of these days. We are, they're all announced on Facebook, so you can look, if you look us up, Radio Jarocho on Facebook, we're there, we, you know, announce. We also have a new album coming up, coming out, and that's gonna be May 10th, so that's exciting, and, well, just